Hi folks, welcome back to my greenhouse. My name's Joe. Today we're going to be looking at the interesting question of whether all prickly succulent plants are actually cacti, so members of the family of Cactaceae, that is, or if not, what are they? And how can we distinguish them?
Okay, so I've got this really nice tray of wonderful prickly succulent plants here. And a question for you. Can you actually pick out the cacti from this assembly? Let's take a look. And it's in fact a bit of a trick question because there is only one member of the family of Cactaceae, one cactus. And well done if you've actually spotted the Echinus aureus here. The Echinus aureus from Mexico. All the other plants, although they look a bit like cacti, so they're, you know, succulent and quite prickly, but they're actually completely unrelated. So what's going on here, and how can we actually tell them apart?
So for that, it really helps to understand a little bit more about the concept of convergent evolution, because it's really relevant to our hobby with cacti and other succulent plants. Simply speaking, the concept of convergent evolution is when different organisms, independently of each other, evolve similar traits or morphologies or shapes. And this is often in response to similar environmental conditions, pressures, or opportunities. So convergent evolution then can create similar or analogous structures and have similar forms or functions. And a good example often used are sharks and dolphins. They look relatively similar despite being entirely unrelated. And many of our succulent plants, of course, are also excellent examples of convergent evolution. In response to similar dry, arid, and hot desert environments or savannas on different continents, many different types of succulent plant forms have evolved. So these succulent plants have adapted in similar ways to their similar environments, but as I say, they're often completely unrelated. Great examples from our own collections of plants, of course, are cacti and euphorbias, as you saw from the plant tray I showed you earlier. Both cacti as well as euphorbias can have quite similar shapes. They're all quite prickly. They are obviously succulent in nature, but let's look at some of the major differences between cacti and euphorbias. First of all, their geographic distribution. Cacti are originally only from the Americas, so Northern, Central, or South America. Euphorbias, on the other hand, are generally from Africa and the Middle East. They occur worldwide as a family of spurges. However, the succulent euphorbias that we're talking about and that we usually find in our collections are generally from different parts of Africa and the Middle East. Another difference is that cacti actually have spines and euphorbias have thorns. So botanically speaking, there is a big difference. Spines, which is what cacti have, are actually modified sharp-pointed leaves. Thorns, on the other hand, are modified sharp-pointed stems. Right, so you might say that all sounds very theoretical. How can I actually distinguish in my day-to-day gardening between the cactus and its spines and the euphorbia with its thorns? So the feature to look out for, and that is unique to cacti only, are so-called areoles. Areoles are small, roundish, cushiony bumps, usually grayish, whitish, or yellowish in color, These areoles are actually features from which the spines grow. The spines, often a central, a longer central spine, surrounded by smaller radial spines. These areoles are unique to cacti. Euphorbias, on the other hand, do not have areoles. Euphorbias have thorns that occur usually in pairs. So no radial display on areoles. So basically, take a close look at how the prickly features on your plant are actually arranged, whether they come out of an areole and are more radially distributed coming out of that areole, then you'll be looking at a cactus, or whether the prickly features occur usually in pairs, not coming out of an areole, well then high chances are you're looking at a succulent euphorbia. Something that is unique to the euphorbias is a white sap, a white milky sap, which bleeds out of the plant when the outer skin is scratched or damaged. This sap is poisonous, be careful. Now, should you have touched it, immediately wash your fingers. In my greenhouse, I love growing various examples of convergent evolution next to each other. These are all plants that may appear quite similar in their shape and morphology, but are actually literally from continents apart and are actually totally unrelated. So here again, you know, two members of the cacti family. These are Astrophytum ornatums. And next to one of our euphorbias again, this is Euphorbia horrida, a really nice euphorbia, which with its thorns actually could be mistaken for a cactus. And then here we've got again two completely unrelated plants. It's an agave Victoria regina, and this is an Echeveria agavoides. It's a hybrid, the lipstick, so-called lipstick hybrid. Really beautiful plant. A little bit similar in its morphology to the agave, but as I say, completely unrelated. And for completeness, here's another Echeveria. I hope you found this video useful and interesting. If you did, I'd really appreciate, as always, if you clicked a like, and even better, if you subscribe to my channel, and you'll get automatic updates of the next video being uploaded. Thanks so much. Happy growing. Take care. Bye-bye.